Hi, I'm Farah and I'm a student currently studying at Chichester College, and today I'm going to be talking about the functions of the skin. This follows up from a previous video that's already been posted on the YouTube channel covering the layers of the skin, but just in case you've forgotten, I'll give you a quick overview. So the skin is made up of three distinct layers: the epidermis, the dermis, and the subcutaneous layer, also known as the hypodermis. The surface of the skin is covered in an acid mantle, which is a water in oil emulsion formed from a mixture of sweat and sebum. It is also covered with mineral and organic substances such as urea, lactic acid, and amino acids. These substances make the skin surface slightly acidic. So just to the left-hand side, I've put a diagram of the skin so you can see each layer. So the first function of the skin is sensation. The skin contains approximately 5 million tiny sensory cells. These sensory cells enable us to respond to sensations that are applied to the surface of the skin, for example, touch, pressure, and vibration. The cells that respond to environmental changes send information to the brain, where the sensation is then perceived. Sensory nerve endings are located mainly in the dermis, but some free nerves end in the epidermis. The next function is temperature regulation. This is where the body needs to be maintained at a constant temperature of about 36.8 degrees Celsius to function correctly. The skin responds to an increase of temperature by dilating the blood vessels in the dermis, also known as vasodilation, to radiate heat away from the body where it has been open to element. This then causes the skin to sweat. As the sweat evaporates, it takes the heat away from the skin's surface, allowing the body to cool. If the body gets too cold, the blood vessels constrict, known as vasoconstriction, to keep the heat nearer to the essential organs of the body. This is where shivering makes the muscles contract. This muscle contraction produces energy to keep warm. Heat loss from the skin is affected by the environment and the amount and type of clothing worn. So here I've just put a diagram of vasodilation on the left and vasoconstriction on the right. The next function is absorption. The skin is not totally waterproof. It allows certain substances to be absorbed in a limited capacity. Some examples of substances that can be absorbed are nicotine, hormones, and steroids. When these substances enter the skin, they can be absorbed by the cells of the epidermis, through the sweat glands, or through the hair shafts. The next function is protection. The skin forms a water-resistant seal over the body. It is very hard-wearing and acts as a defence against chemicals, microorganisms, dehydration and damage. Sebum, water and other substances are secreted onto the skin's surface to keep it waterproof, supple and flexible. The surface of the skin is slightly acidic, ranging from a pH of around 4.5 to 5.5, which prevents harmful bacteria growing. Melanin acts as a chemical filter absorbing and reflecting UV radiation, which is why as beauty therapists we say it's so important to wear SPF daily. The hypodermis, also known as the subcutaneous layer, cushions the underlying bones and organs to prevent damage from external forces and pressure. The hypodermis and the dermis together protect the body against temperature changes. Excretion is the next function. Excretion is the process that our bodies use to get rid of water or unwanted substances. The skin is a minor excretory organ. It excretes sweat, which contains water, sodium and potassium chlorides, known as salts, urea and uric acids, and an aromatic substance which gives the body its personal odour. So if we don't wash our clothes or skins regularly, bacteria will break down our sweat, causing unpleasant odours. Secretion is the process that our bodies use to release substances needed by the body. For example, sebum is secreted into the hair follicles and onto the skin. Sebum is an oily substance that keeps the hair and skin soft, supple and flexible, and it can also give them a shiny appearance. The last function of the skin is production of vitamin D. Vitamin D is produced in the skin as a response to exposure to ultraviolet radiation, known as UVB. If you block UVB rays, you will prevent the production of vitamin D. Dark skins need more exposure to UVB to produce the same amount of vitamin D than a light skin because it contains more melanin, which restricts the absorption of UVB rays. So just to recap on this video, there are seven main functions of the skin, which are sensation, temperature regulation, absorption, protection, excretion, secretion, and production of vitamin D. We'll be right back.